Hi children, today we are going to study lesson 3, fiber to fabric. Fabrics means clothes, in Hindi vastra or kapda. Then fabrics are made up of yarns and yarns are further made up of fibers. We use different kinds of fabrics for making clothes. Then example, our school uniform, pants, shirt, skirt, then shawls, bedsheet, curtain, etc. are all made of different fabrics. Even in some school bags and gunny bags are made up of another fabrics. Then next we have to discuss variety of fabrics. First, variety of fabrics. Fabrics means clothes. Then we use different kinds of fabrics. Example, cotton, wool, silk and synthetic. What are the different types of fabrics? Cotton, wool, jute, then silk and synthetic. These are the different kinds of fabrics. Cotton, wool, jute, then silk, synthetic. These are the different kinds of fabrics or clothes. Then cotton. Cotton is used in summer season and wool used in winter season, and some silk, jute, synthetic type clothes used in neither hot or cold. Then yarn. Yarn means yarn is a long thread which is used for making fabrics. You look, our clothes is made up of different kinds of fabrics there. Then fabrics is made up of yarn. Yarn means group of a long thread. Then next is fiber. Fiber means fiber, the thin strands of a thread that are made up of still thinner strands called fibers. Fibers means group of thread or strands is called fibers. Then fibers are of two types, natural fibers and synthetic fibers. What are they? Natural fibers and synthetic fibers. Fibers are two types, natural fibers and synthetic fibers. Natural fibers is obtained from plants and animals. It is obtained from plants and animals. Then example, plants. Plants and animals. The fibers of some fabrics such as cotton, jute, silk and wool are obtained from plants and animals. These are called natural fibers. Then cotton and jute are example of plant fibers. They are an example of plants, cotton and jute. Then animals example, wool and silk. Then natural fibers obtained from plants and animals. Then plants example, cotton and jute. Animals, wool and silk. Then cotton is obtained from cotton plant, jute also jute plant. Then animals, wool from sheep, then goat, some camels, rabbits, etc. Cotton and jute are example of fibers obtained from plants. Wool and silk fibers are obtained from animals. Wool is obtained from the fleece of sheep or goat. Fleece means hair. Then sheep and goat hairs there. These are made up of wool. It is also obtained from the hair of rabbits, yak and camels. Silk fiber is drawn from the cocoon of silkworm. Then cotton is from cotton plant. Cotton plant, jute from jute plant, then wool, example, sheep, goat, then camel, rabbit, then silk from silkworm. Silk is obtained from silkworm. Then these are the natural fibers. Synthetic fiber means it is man-made or artificial. Synthetic fiber, another name is man-made and artificial. Man-made or another name, synthetic fiber, another name is man-made or artificial. Example, nylon, polyester and acrylic. These are the example of synthetic fibers. Then fibers are made from chemical substances which are not obtained from plant or animal sources. These are called synthetic fibers. Some example of synthetic fibers are polyester, nylon and acrylic. Then we are going to study some plant sources. First one is cotton plant. Some plant sources. Some plant sources. First one is cotton plant. Cotton is obtained from cotton plant. It is in warm climate growing plant there. It is grown in the fields. Cotton plants are usually grown at places having black soil and warm climate. Their soil is black soil and warm climate. Black soil and warm climate. The fruits of the cotton plant or cotton balls are about the size of a lemon. That means cotton is grown in cotton balls. It is obtained from cotton balls. From these balls, cotton is usually picked by hand. Fibers are then separated from the seeds by combing. This process is called ginning. That means cotton is usually picked by hand. Separating from seeds is called ginning. Ginning means separation of seeds. Ginning means separation of seeds by hand. Fibers are separated from the seeds by combing. This process is called ginning. Then ginning was traditionally done by hands. Then hands using. Nowadays machines are also used for ginning. Then next is jute. Jute fiber is obtained from the stem of the jute plant. It is obtained from stem of the jute plant. Stem of the jute plant. Then cotton is obtained from cotton balls or fruit of the cotton plant. Jute is obtained from stem of the jute plant. It is cultivated during the rainy season. Rainy season in India, jute is mainly grown in West Bengal, Bihar and Assam. The jute plant is normally harvested when it is at flowering stage. Jute plant is harvested in flowering stage. The stems of the harvested plants are immersed in water for a few days. The stems, rot and fibers are separated by hand. That means this jute plant stem is immersed in water and few days after separated by using hands. Okay, once more, fiber means group of thread. Then fibers are of two types, natural fibers and synthetic fibers. Natural fiber is obtained from plants and animals. Then plants example, cotton and jute. Then animals, wool and silk. Then cotton is obtained from cotton plant. Jute is obtained from jute plant. Then animals giving wool. Wool giving animals, sheep, goat, camel, rabbit, etc. Then silk is obtained from silk worm. Then next is synthetic fiber. Synthetic fiber, another name is man-made or artificial. An example, nylon, polyester, acrylic. This detailed study in 7th class. Then another, some plant sources, cotton plant, cotton balls there. These balls inside seeds there. These seeds separating from combing by use hand. This separation of seeds by cotton balls is called ginning. Then jute stem of the jute plant. In jute's stem is using in a rainy season, is harvesting in rainy season. Okay, thanks to all.